Katie Bell was a British witch with an unknown blood status. She was born in 1979 to Mr. and Mrs. Bell. She attended Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry from 1990 to 1997. She played as the chaser for the Gryffindor Quidditch team, and this is the life of Katie Bell. Katie received her Hogwarts letter in April 1990 at the age of 11. She presumably purchased her wand from Gary Collivander. During the welcoming feast, she was sorted into the Gryffindor house, but the Hat had wondered whether to keep her in Gryffindor or Hufflepuff before finally keeping her in Gryffindor. She was in hot stall, meaning she was means the Hat took 5 minutes to keep her to choose her house. Her head of the house was Professor Minerva McGonagall. During her first year, she easily befriended Katie Leung and some other girls who were also in her Gryffindor year. She was very good in flying lessons, as she later played in the Gryffindor Quidditch team. She was a year younger than Fred and George Weasley. During her second year, Harry Potter came to Hogwarts and was sorted into Gryffindor house as well. Katie was selected to play as the chaser by the captain and keeper of the team, Oliver Wood. She played alongside as chaser with Alicia Spinett and Angelina Johnson. Fred and George Weasley played as the Peters, and Harry, though in his first year, was selected to play as the seeker by Professor Minerva McGonagall. During the first Quidditch match of Katie, Harry and the year against Slytherin House, Katie was hit by a bludger in her head. She did not get any injury and continued to play. She scored the first goal of the Gryffindor team. They won the match by 170 to 60 points when Harry caught the snitch before the Slytherin Seeker Smigs did. During the third and final match of the season against Ravenclaw House, Harry wasn't there at the match as he was in the hospital wing. The Gryffindor team lost their match and suffered the greatest loss they ever because they had one player less. They lost the match by 170 to 20 points. Katie was present at the end of term feast when Gryffindor won the House Cup after 8 years, when Professor Dumbledore gave Harry, Ron, Hermione and Neville extra points and making them win this the House Cup. In her third year, she was present at the training when new Slytherin seeker Draco Malfoy called Hermione Granger a mudblood. During the first match, Katie was present when a mad bludger was attacking Harry. Though they won when Harry caught the snitch, Harry was very injured and broke his arm. But thanks to Professor Lockhart, he lost all his bones of that arm too. They had won the match against Slytherin team by the score of 190 to 30. And Katie had scored 20 points during the match. The second match and the third match of the season had been cancelled due to the opening of the Chamber of Secrets and the students being attacked. She was present at the end of term feast when Gryffindor House won the House Cup for the second running year. She clapped happily with the other rest of the Gryffindor House students. In her fourth year, Sirius Black had escaped from Azkaban and was thought to be after Harry. During the first match of her fourth year, they were supposed to play against Slytherin, but due to Draco Malfoy's injury, they played against Hufflepuff, captained by Cedric Diggory. Katie and the other chasers admired Cedric's looks, and during the match, the Dementors entered the stadium, which caused Harry to fall from a height of 50 feet, and first time made his team lose. After the match, Harry was sent in the hospital wing, surrounded by the Gryffindor team, Ron and Hermione. After he fell, his Nimbus 2000 hit the Whomping Willow and broke. And the next day, again with the entire Gryffindor team, went to meet Harry. In the second match against Ravenclaw, Harry, now full fit and on his new broom Firebolt, which was said to be the best broom in the world at that time, caught the snitch before Ravenclaw seeker Cho Chang and made his team win by 230 Gryffindor score and 30 Ravenclaw. The final match of the season was against Slytherin team. Kathy had taken the second penalty and scored a goal. It was 70 Gryffindor and 10 Slytherin when Kathy had already made 3 goals. Then Harry finally caught the Snitch and narrowly defeated Draco Malfoy, the Slytherin Seeker, and made his team win the Quidditch Cup for after 7 years. After the match, the Gryffindor team was given the Quidditch Cup, and Professor McGonagall and the entire Gryffindor Quidditch team were crying and tears of happiness streaming from their eyes. During her 5th year, Hogwarts was host to the Triwizard Tournament, and she was present to welcome the Bobbattons and Durmstrang delegations. She was also very excited to see Victor Crumb. In her 5th year, she visited made a prefect. She came into her 7th year now, but she wasn't made a head girl. But she wasn't even made a Quidditch team captain. Instead, Harry was made the Quidditch team captain. During the tryouts, Harry said that he didn't need to check Katie, as he knew how she played. And Katie said that he had to make a fair tryout and didn't take others just because they were his friends. And Katie played very well and made back into the team, along playing now with new chasers Ginny Weasley and Demelza Robbins. On October 15th, Kathy went to the Hogsmeade trip along with her friend Leanne, and while she was at Hogsmeade in the Three Broomsticks, Madam Rosmeta, the innkeeper of Three Broomsticks, put an imperious curse on Kathy, which has and Madam Rosmeta herself was under the imperious curse of Draco Malfoy. And she gave Kathy a opal necklace which was cursed and to give that to Professor Dumbledore in order to kill him. But the plan failed when returning to Hogwarts, a small part in Kathy's glove was torn and it touched the packet, and she cursed, but she did not die but got much injuries and had to spend 6 months in the St. Mungo's Hospital for visiting maladies and injuries. That year, Battle of the Astronomy Tower took place, but Katie didn't take part in it and didn't know what had happened. But she was present at Dumbledore's funeral and paid her headmaster her last tributes. After Albus Dumbledore's death, Voldemort took over the Ministry of Magic and as well as Hogwarts, and Professor Snape was made the new headmaster. Katie also came back when Hogwarts needed her and fought bravely in the Battle of Hogwarts. This tells her that she was a skilled duelist, as she survived the Battle of Hogwarts, where many great witch and wizards died. She was present when in the Great Hall when Harry killed Voldemort. After the Battle of Hogwarts ended, she was sitting with Parvati Patel, Alicia Spinett, and Angelina Johnson. It is unknown what happened to her or what she did after the Battle of Hogwarts, and it is also unknown that whom did she marry. But it is known that she was a good, kind, and always helping friend to those who are good to her.
And that is all for the life of Katie Bell, and I really hope you have enjoyed this video. And if you have enjoyed it and I deserve your like, then please hit the like button below the video and share this video as much as you can, and leave your comments below as well. I would love to read your comments, whether they are an appreciation, suggestion, or a criticism. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed it yet. And you can also follow me on Instagram at justmeet268, and you will find a link given in the descriptions to follow me on Instagram. Some of my other videos also might be appearing on the left hand side, right hand side of the screen. Please do watch them, like them, share them, and leave your comments below them as well. I know that you like it like that. I wait designer, check the name on the tag. White fox fur on my jacket.